Hello again, Trevor from Allen's Music Centre with our next video for the Hobby Organist channel. Lots of things to cover today, and the first thing I want to do is something that we have never actually mentioned in any of the videos, and it dawned on me this morning that it would be something that would be very handy for everybody to know about. And this is a thing that we call a hard reset or factory reset on the Lowrey organs. Now Lowrey organs, like any modern instrument now, behind all these buttons and screens, there's a very powerful computer that makes the whole organ operate, makes everything work. And sometimes, like all of us, that computer can get a bit confused, or it can just get itself into a bit of a tiz-wars and it doesn't know quite what to do with itself. Now, when that happens to us, we generally have something we can do to try and sort ourselves out, but computers are not able to sort themselves out that easily sometimes. Sometimes they need to be told, right, start again, complete afresh, forget everything you know, and just start back from square one. And that's what we call a factory reset. And probably half of the phone calls we get from people with Lowrey organs are having trouble with them, or something strange has happened, or they're not getting any sound. Probably over half of those phone calls we can sort out by talking people through this thing we call a hard reset. Now, it's actually a tricky thing to do, which is why it's a bit of a challenge talking people through on the phone with it. So it's kind of ideal for me to show you in a video so you can actually see what I'm doing. So the first thing we do is we start with the organ switched off. So there's nothing, the organ's not on at all. And we need our right hand. And what we need is the little finger of our right hand up here. And we put that little finger on the very, very top C of the upper keyboard. So not the lower, but on the upper. And the top C is actually the very, very top note on this end. I hold that down with my little finger. With my next finger, my fourth finger, I hold down the note B. With my next finger, I hold down A. So at this point, we're using our top three fingers to hold down the top three white notes on the upper keyboard. Now this is the important bit. We miss out G. And we hold down the F with our second finger, and then with our thumb, we hold down E. So I'm actually holding down five white notes, and I'm holding them down quite firmly because it's easy for one of them to try and pop up. So I'm pushing quite hard to make sure I'm holding them all down. So from the top, I'm holding C, B, A, missing the G, F, and E. Going up, it's E, F, A, B, C. And I'm holding all five of them down, and I'm going to carry on holding them down. I'll turn the organ back on, and I'm carrying on holding them. I'm holding them, and I'm holding them. What I'm looking for on the screen is the word total reset. There we go. Come now on the screen. Now, depending on which organ you have, if you have an E-series, it takes a little bit longer for that to come up. But on the SU series and the A series, as you just saw, that came up very quickly, and you immediately heard the noise of me holding down all those keys. And so as soon as you see the words total reset, you know that it's worked. So let's do it one more time. We turn the organ off, we take our right hand, take our little finger, put it on the very top C, put it on the note B next to it, the A next to it, we miss out the G, we hold down the F, and the E. We're holding down five notes, and so we're making sure we're holding down firmly. The most common mistake with this is to let some of these fingers here start to drift up while you're holding down the other ones, and because you're concentrating the other ones, right, the other ones start to lift up. So you have to make sure that you're holding them down all firmly. If you are holding them down all firmly and they're right notes in the right order, when you turn on, and I'm going to turn my expression pedal down so you don't hear that noise again, you'll see the words total reset. So we hold that down, we wait a few seconds, carry on holding, and as soon as we see the word total reset, we can let go. Now that has wiped the memory of the organ clean, that's reset the computer back to square one, and the important thing to remember that if you do that, you are going to lose any presets that you had stored in the organ. So anything that you had stored in the bank presets here, will have been wiped out completely, because the whole point of this is to put the computer back to square one. So if you do have any problems with your Lowrey organ, and it's doing something a bit weird, or you turned it on and there's no sound, then try that five finger reset and say, more than half the time, it will actually bring the organ back to normal for you. Okay? So that's the first lesson for today. And that's a quite handy one just to keep for the future. The second thing we're going to talk about today is something that keeps coming up, actually. It keeps coming back with emails and questions about this. So I'm going to try and do another presentation on this. And this is talking about what a preset pack or an expansion pack is for a Lowrey organ. This is something that we've been doing for a long time for Lowrey organs. And sometimes it's a bit difficult to appreciate quite what these packs do. We talk about them a lot and we say, oh, just for you one, just for you two, and touch of gold, and all these fancy titles. And we do lots of presentations saying, you know, which organs they work on. But a lot of people are a bit confused as to what an expansion pack actually does. So we're going to just talk about that briefly today. So an expansion pack is essentially a group of additional presets for your Lowrey organ. Every Lowrey organ, as you get it from the factory, is already preloaded by Lowrey with a large number of preset registrations. I'm sitting here at a fantastic Liberty, so of course we have a large number of category presets. We have a large number of ribbon presets that go with the style. So your organ already has lots and lots of presets in it. Question is, why would you want any more? You've already got loads in there. Well, firstly, human nature. It's always nice to have more and have a bigger selection. And secondly, we feel that the approach we take with our presets is different to the ones that you already have in the organ. So these are going to create different sounds, different combinations, different ideas for you to play with. It's important to remember that when we load an expansion pack in and the presets, we're not actually loading in new styles. We're not loading in any new voices. That's not a feature on the Lowrey organ. What we are loading in are all the changes and setup that you would do to create these sounds. The same way as a preset that you've already got on the Lowrey organ. So if I sit down at this organ and I don't know anything about it, I know I can press country, I'm going to get a country sound. Because this button sets everything up for me. It does all the hard work for me. There's an awful lot of experience and cleverness gone into that button to set that sound up for me. Well, it's the same with these presets, is that there's been an awful lot of hard work and time spent creating and crafting these presets for you. There's a video we did earlier near the start of lockdown where I kind of talked through the process of making some presets for the song we did, What a Wonderful World. And that video lasted over an hour and only did about two or three sounds. So there's a lot of hard work and a lot of effort goes into creating these sounds. And there's a lot of expertise that goes into them. You know how to blend things, how to add things together. I always like to use analogies, and it's almost like the analogy of cooking, is that if you have a kitchen full of all the different ingredients and you put somebody in there like myself who doesn't know how to cook, I can be in there all day and I'm not going to make you a decent meal. You can take an experienced chef, put him in that kitchen with those same ingredients, and he'll make you an incredible meal. And it's the same with an organ. You've got all these ingredients here, and it's the skill and the expertise about how to blend them, how to use every single function and feature on the organ to put those sounds together. So that's what you get when you buy an expansion pack, is you get additional presets. And there are two kinds of presets that we do. We do presets which we describe as being generic. Generic means you can use them for anything. They're not designed for anything, a specific song. So for example, if you get a set of presets that give you Dixieland sounds, you can play any Dixieland song with them. In fact, it doesn't even have to be a Dixieland song. You can play anything with those presets. However, in some of our packs, we came up with an idea of what we call In Concert. And they feature in our Just For You packs. And a Just For You pack doesn't just give you lots of additional presets, but it gives you presets which have been programmed and created for a particular song. Because one of the important ways that you can improve your performance on a Lowrey organ is having all the perfect presets and the changes already done for you. So you can play through the song and you press this button, it'll give you the perfect sound for the introduction. We tell you when to use FX and then change preset to another one. And so we talk you through the whole song. In fact, on our main channel, on the Lowrey UK channel on YouTube, we've got dozens and dozens of videos with me doing exactly that. I spend half an hour chatting through how to use those registrations for playing that specific song. So if you have a Just For You pack for your organ, you will find in it that there will be some registrations which are just generally titled. I've got Just For You one here, the first one, and There are some presets where it just says magical musicals or simply strings or Dixie Parade. So those registrations will set you up to play on the organ, and you can play any song you want with them. Later on in this pack, there are some which are called in concert. Let's get low and flip through. There's a lot on this pack. For example, The Lion King and The Circle of Life. So there's a set of registrations here that set the organ up perfectly for playing through that entire song. And if you look on the videos on our main channel, there's a video of me spending half an hour chatting through how to use those registrations, those presets, to play that song. And with all that stuff done for you, it can really enhance your performance. Now, one of the packs that we've been doing for a little while is a pack called Touch of Gold. And this is a pack which works in any organ from the Stirling upwards. So when Lowrey introduced the model called the Stirling Edition, we thought it'd be fun to call the pack for A Touch of Gold. See what we did there? And of course, it works on any subsequent organ. So the Touch of Gold pack will work in the Stirling Edition, it will work in the Symphony, it will work in the Symphony Showcase, it works in the Patriot in America, it works on Liberty. We've done a version of it that works on the Imperial as well. So what does a Touch of Gold pack actually give you? Well, let's load it in and have a look and open up the pack. Now, the idea behind this pack, when we first did it, is that when the Stirling Edition came out, it had a unique feature in it which we hadn't seen on a Lowrey organ before. And that feature allowed us as programmers to really get into the voices and start editing them and changing them to suit how we wanted them to sound. So rather than sitting down at the organ and choosing, for example, a clarinet sound, and that's the clarinet that you've got, and if you don't like it, tough luck, that's the clarinet. But what we're able to do from the Stirling onwards is to take that clarinet sound and do lots of changes to it. We could change its envelope, we could change its brightness, we could change its panning, we could put digital effects on it. We could do all kinds of things to change the way that that clarinet sounded. And we had lots of fun. In fact, we were editing and changing voices quite a lot. And so the first set of registrations that you find on this pack are called Super Solos. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to USB. I've just checked that I've got the stick in the drawer. And I'm going to choose Load Presets. And we're going to choose the very first one at the top there, Super Solos. And press All. There we go. So this set of registrations is slightly different, because I've said in previous ones, when you load in our software packs, you always load the sounds into A. Well, this one has loaded registrations into B as well. And the reason why we did that is in A, we had the registrations just setting up the sound. In B, we actually put a rhythm with them as well. So let's go on to B, so we'll have a bit of rhythm with them. So the first one we did here is actually the sound I was talking about, was clarinet. So in England, in Europe, we love a nice, deep, rich clarinet. In fact, we have a very famous clarinet player who sadly has passed away, Acca Bilk, and he had a very, very famous song called A Strange on the Shore. And this clarinet sound is perfect for playing that kind of song. That song with it, because this is a generic registration, so any nice slow swing number is nice. So that is a new clarinet sound that, yes, you could recreate yourself if you knew how to do all the reprogramming, had the experience and so forth, but the beauty of the pack is that all of that is done for you just by pressing that button. Number two is one we call Super Sax, and this works nicely again with the slow swing and things. On this one we've set it up with a bossa nova, so you could do a nice... See the glide in there? You've got that sound, but if you don't want to play it with a bossa nova, or you don't even play it with a rhythm, you can just... Number three is we did the same stuff with the trumpet. In fact, this is a great one for playing... with Wonderful World style, if you want to play What a Wonderful World, but we enjoy playing Summertime, so we call this the Super Trumpet. Presets, you always like to put a split on there as well. Number four is with lovely super trombone. Trombones, obviously, we think about in the Dixieland style, but of course they use a lot in jazz music. So we wanted to make a nice gentle trombone that's not raspy and loud, just a nice smooth. From the Prestige, is that they were able to give the instruments a lot more clarity, make them a lot brighter, and that really made them sound a lot more realistic. And one of the standout voices for us when we went over to these organs was the violin. It had you could hear the bowing on it. And so we had great fun tweaking that and brightening it up to really bring out that bowiness on there that really made it sound unique. And we put it with a lovely gentle waltz. Presets up without using the dynamic keying. So if you want to use dynamic keying makes the keyboard touch sensitive. So the harder you touch it, the louder and harsher the sound becomes. And we're going to talk about the dynamic keying a lot more in another video, because it's just something that's very important to me. But this is a good example with the violin sound, is that without dynamic keying, the violin is lovely, but every note is the same, because it's all coming out at the same volume. So as you put the dynamic keying on, we then have control over the way that the violin sound is played, how the violin is played. So the same way as a real violinist would be striking the bow or stroking it, the way that we play the keys determines how that violin sounds. So for example, if I hit the note, If I stroke the notes, much smoother. And so we can actually really transform that sound. And so if I play, let's play If I Was a Rich Man, I'm not going to change any settings on the organ. I'm just going to play, just change the way I'm playing the keys. Kind of exaggerating it there, but you can hear that completely different change in the tone of the violin just from the way that I'm playing it. You could play that Zardas, whatever. Something like that, very fun. Incidentally, actually, going off on a complete tangent, that If I Was a Rich Man, there is a fantastic style that's been around for a long time in the Lowrey Organs. Under the polka category called Folk Wedding. And it's one of those styles that's been around in most of the organs. I mean, you're going back right to Royal and Sensation SE, all of the Lowrey organs. And we tend to overlook some of the rhythms that are earlier on in this styles list. But this folk one, let's just play it quickly, is incredible for playing If I Were a Rich Man. Listen. Number six is the oboe sound. I love an oboe. I always found the original oboe on the Lowreys to be a little bit sharp for me. I like it to be a little bit mellower. And so I did my own oboe sound here. Floating away style. actually. That particular style is brilliant. If you've ever thought about trying to compose or make songs up, sometimes a starting style like that is a brilliant thing because it gives you this lovely platform. So you could just start with that style. And just hold a chord down. Just see how that feels with you. Now I'm holding down C there, so just try playing on the white notes. Just take two chords like C and F and just fiddle around with a melody on there, and you'd be surprised actually how effective it can be. In fact, I'm sure that's how most of the music you listen to, if you're doing yoga and they have this tinkly music, that's all it's doing, is just these little bits in the background. So yeah, that's our oboe. And what we've got, number 7, the super flute. Again, another one of my favourite voices on these organs, because again that flute has got such character to it. We'll put the dynamic keying on, you've got this low. You've got this lovely bit, you can hear the breath in there, the lips. Well, we've married this up with Parrot Buffet. I've never had parrot before, but they call this style Parrot Buffet. Nice kind of Caribbean, relaxing. So your own arrangement if you want to do something. In fact, a lot of times if I do something wrong the first time around, just do it wrong the second time around and it sounds like it was deliberate in the first place. Number 8 is panpipe. Of course, we do a lot in the UK with when playing panpipes with the Lonely Shepherd. But there can be a lot of fun with sort of a more up-tempo music. We've got this merengue. Super guitar, yes. Now one of the new voices introduced on from the Sterling onwards is this wonderful resonator guitar. There's lots of tweaking, lots of adjustment to really bring out that. If you play that with dynamic keying, it actually bends the notes. But we won't put that on there. We'll put this with a nice 6/8 guitar rhythm. I think the tempo is a little bit slower than that one. So you can lift the tempo up, or you can play something a bit different from playing that 6/8 guitar. We always play House of the Rising Sun, but there's a beautiful cavatina song that perfectly with that. Voice to accompany there. Normally that 6/8 rhythm uses electric guitar. We changed it to an acoustic guitar so it match the acoustic guitar there. And then finally on number 10 we have a beautiful sound of cello. Beautiful melancholy kind of sound of cello. So expressive. We put it here with the lullaby rhythm so you can play. Fun there, playing through these 10 completely new solo sounds that we managed to load into the organ from the Touch of Gold pack. And that's just the first track on here. There's actually 5 tracks. The second lot is a selection of what we call worship presets. So if we're playing worship music, there's lots of gospel things in there. I haven't got time to play through them all, unfortunately. The third track, a bit early for this one, but there's a whole 50 registrations for playing Christmas songs. So if you like playing Christmas music, we can put in the USB there, load presets, and choose a Christmas category. There we go. And this particular setup actually loads in all 5 banks with registrations for playing your Christmas songs. So for example, the first one is for playing all your slow swing ones, you know. Is I'm playing their Christmas songs with them, but of course you can play actually any songs you want with them. Tinkle pianos in there, which we were thinking of playing for the very first Christmas of all. Back here we did some lovely choirs. Christmas time, but apart from that you've got all these lovely sounds. Playing any kind of music with a choir. That think it was on the radio the other night. That's why it suddenly came into my head. The Titanic music. Remember when everybody was playing that? And don't hear it so often. That's a beautiful melody in that. But no, these choirs are perfect. So Christmas registrations there, but you don't necessarily have to use them for Christmas. Oh, Bank D, yeah, it's got some great on. Christmas songs at registration, you pay. Why was that? And Dee had some lovely lovely sounds on the Christmas sets, but say not necessarily just for playing Christmas songs. And then USB load presets. What else do we have on the stick? We have the Less Is More set of registrations and Around the World. We haven't got time to go through them all now, kind of taking a long time playing through those. But that's just a taster of the kind of things that an expansion pack gives you. So it gives you lots of new ideas, lots of new sounds, lots of different ways of using the styles. And the beauty of it is all the hard work's done for you. You get a little booklet with them that tells you what registrations you're going to find and suggest what songs you could play with them. And then if you get a Just For You pack, then you can follow the tuition that we put in with the videos to use the registrations to make a performance of a particular song. And so they're designed to help you sound as good as possible on the Lowrey organ and to have as much fun as possible. That's what it's all about, is using this incredible technology and these incredible instruments to have fun and making you sound like the star, which is what it's all about. And you having fun at home. So I think this one's been quite a long video, but I hope it's been informative. We've covered lots of things there. Remember at the beginning we did the five finger reset. That's always the handy thing to remember. We've talked about what an expansion pack is, and we've played through some of the sounds here on the Touch of Gold pack, which is still available. It's one of the very popular pack that we did, and saves you heard some lovely sounds on there. We'll be back tomorrow, and I think we need to do the orchestral and the solo buttons. That's one of the questions that's come up that we haven't covered yet, so we need to do that. And we need to follow up question on the glide, which we will include as well tomorrow. So take care, be safe, and I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye bye.